side that won that one. Experienced trio, Ankufeyev, Denisov and Zhirkov making way for Glushakov, Kokorin and Vladimir Gavrilov, who is in goal. Anyukov, Ignashevich, Shirakov and Kurtsakov, ever present at last summer's European Championships. All 11 players play their club football in Russia. Five are with Zenit, two Anji, two CSKA Moscow, one Lokomotiv and one Dynamo. Well, there'll be no restrictions on substitutions tonight. Brazil used five on Thursday in Geneva against Italy. Number 18, Osvaldo, is 25 years old, but if he comes on tonight, it will be his debut. Russia have named Igor Denisov amongst their subs, but he has been suffering with illness over the last 48 hours. It will be a big surprise if he comes on. Fabio Capello, well known in these parts, of course, the former England coach, 4 years in charge of the national side in England, had a poor World Cup, qualified for the Euros before resigning a year ago, and in the opposite dugout, another man very well known in these parts, former Chelsea boss, Big Phil Scolari. In charge tonight, arguably the best referee in the English Premier League, Howard Webb, who took charge of the World Cup final back in 2010. So it's Brazil in those famous gold jerseys who get us underway, attacking the goal away to our right-hand side. This the 10th time these nations have met on a football field. Brazil have won 7 of the previous 9, just the one victory for Russia. And that came some 33 years ago, then known as the Soviet Union, a 2-0 victory in Rio. Also managed a 2-all draw there in 1965, but the other 7 all finished in defeat, including the last 3. Kaká, who has been out of the international side for some time, but back in the plans of the international scene since last September. Player who has played in the last 3 World Cup finals. It's his dream to be there next year on home soil. Glushakov, one of the trio that have been brought in for this one by Fabio Capello. Now Fezulin, one of the 5 players in the side from Zenit St. Petersburg. Hassled by Neymar, unfairly in the eyes of referee Howard Webb. Neymar yet to score in 2013, but finished 2012 in fabulous form. 8 goals in 6 games. Good challenge there from the Brazilian captain Thiago Silva. And another free kick given against Neymar. There's half an opportunity for Alexander Kurtsakov here. Good early thinking. The ball whipped in by Bistrov. Kurtsakov denied by smart defending by Thiago Silva. Silva, who's been out of action for Paris Saint-Germain of late, just come back into the team. In fact, he missed 7 games through January and February with a calf injury. Julio Cesar, who plays his club football nowadays just down the road at Queen's Park Rangers. Ignashevich, number 4, is looking to thump this one. It's travelling. Julio Cesar does enough. More work for the Brazilian defence to do. And Fernando managed to get something on it, and Brazil able to get it away, but that was well struck by Ignashevich. And here come Brazil on the counter. Shirakov now for Russia. Russia have been in fantastic form since Fabio Capello took over. Smart save by Julio Cesar. Well struck, awkward bounce just in front of him. The bounce was favourable to Brazil. Just move late, didn't it? Julio Cesar got both hands to it. Down the years, Sergei Ignashevich has only managed 5 goals in his previous 85 games. They are something of collector's items. Goals from Ignashevich. Fred. Neymar. Marcelo. Away by Ignashevich. This time the foul by Hernanes. I think the next extremely impressive season with Lazio, helped them climb to third position in Serie A, and also through to the quarterfinals of the Europa League. Mishchenko. First touch for Vladimir Gavrilov. Came on at half time in that friendly against Iceland last month. Akinfeev retiring in the summer. Igor Akinfeev of CSKA Moscow, now the undisputed number one for Russia. He's played in all 4 of their World Cup qualifiers. Good challenge by Ashchenko. Not a bad run either. Finally impeded by Fernando, and the free kick quickly taken. Shirakov beat himself, but he's won it back here off Dani Alves. Russia certainly have started the brighter of the two sides, but here's Neymar. Oh, beautiful touch. Options to his left, held on to it for too long. There goes Fred. Good work though by Kokorin. Ignashevich for Anyukov. Seven games unbeaten, Russia, since Fabio Capello took charge. They've won 5 of those games. Important victories coming in the World Cup qualifiers. Top of Group 6 with maximum 12 points from their 4 games. Tough test this for Brazil. Of course, the current FIFA rankings have Brazil 18. Russia, 8 above in 10th spot. It's the lowest that Brazil have ever been. It's all to do with calculation method, which gives a higher weighting to World Cup qualifiers than friendlies. So given the fact that all the forward by Thiago Silva, it's a little bit careless by Berezutsky. Recovery by Glushakov. Won by Dani Alves. Years, Brazil have enjoyed 7 spells as the undisputed number one in those FIFA rankings, including one spell of 6 years between 1995 and 2001. And a 5-year spell between 2002 and 2007, so it's something of a shock to see them so low at the moment. Again by Kokorin. Stitch defending for the second time this evening from Thiago Silva. Russia certainly look the more likely at the moment. Anyukov stopped by Marcelo. Lucky enough to settle for the throw. Anyukov three-quarters of a very experienced back four. That's only the left-back, Eschenko, who has less than 60 caps. Like a foul it was. Hernanez, the culprit. Not ready for the free kick. Banozitski, Kurtsakov, Ignashevich, the likely targets here for Viktor Feyzulin. Kokorin is in there too, being guarded by Kaká. It's deep towards Kokorin. Shikharov couldn't get a shot in, and it came off Dani Alves and behind. Well, that was very, very worrying from a Brazilian point of view. For some while, Shirokov had a stab at it, missed it from this header across from Kokorin, and Dani Alves just stuck a boot out, and quite frankly, it could have gone anywhere. Instead of a first goal, it's a first corner, and that's not the best of clearances from Thiago Silva. Thanks for handball. It's an opportunity, though, that splays wide. The whistler's gone anyway. It was Kurtsakov who had the final strike, but there was a shout in amongst all that for a possible handball. There. The right hand of Fernando. The whistle had already gone. Kurtsakov hurrying his shot well wide. Brazil living dangerously at the moment. Just haven't found any rhythm at the minute. But here's Oscar. The more than a few Chelsea fans here again supporting the Brazilian number 7 and the number 4, David Luiz. Big favourites at Stamford Bridge. Oscar in particular is having a terrific season. He's played in just about all of their games as well. He's played in 49 of their matches this season. Fernando, Marcelo, drifts one forward. Malikov, got a touch to get it away. Flag had been raised anyway. Fred just ahead of the last defender as the ball was played forward. Feyzulin. Eschenko. Kurtsakov. Taking them all on. And eventually the whistle goes against Fernando. Kurtsakov has already scored 3 goals in the World Cup qualifying campaign for Russia. And a cup in the victory against Israel. The all-important winner against Portugal. Israel and Portugal, the two teams just behind Russia. I say just behind, they're 4 points behind, having played a game more. And they drew 3-3 in Israel on Friday. Here's Kurtsakov, plays to the corner and wins it off David Luiz. And no sign at the moment of this pattern in the game altering. Brazil very much on the back foot. Russia preparing their second corner. Called in towards Ignashevich with a free header. Shirokov has missed it again, and Kurtsakov got forced in at the back post. Well, how on earth does Shirokov find that amount of space again? And for the second time in these opening 12 minutes, he misses a really good opportunity from that header down from Ignashevich. Kurtsakov blocked by good defensive work by Hernanez. Away from Dani Alves. Disappointing cross though. Poor clearance. And still Brazil can't clear their lines. In by Feyzulin. Away by Fred, the centre forward. having to do the defensive work for Brazil. It's a sign of the way the game has been going in these opening 30 minutes as Russia prepare their third corner. Disappointing delivery away by Dani Alves. Neymar unable to get hold of it. Shirakov. Russia's throw. Leschenko looking for Kurtsakov. Brilliant back heel. Shirakov now, not much to aim for in red in the box. He's won another corner. Russia relishing this challenge. You do sense that they need to make this count. Corner number four. Keeper stays at home, hooked away by David Luiz. Maybe an opportunity for Brazil on the counter if Oscar can use it wisely. Unable to do so. And instead it's Eschenko for Russia. Shirakov. David Luiz steps in. Smart save by Julio Cesar. Bistroff it was who let fly. No let up as Brazil look to get at Russia. 15 minutes gone, there or thereabouts. And Julio Cesar and his defenders have been worked hard. Meanwhile, Gabulov in the Russian goal has been a virtual spectator. Dani Alves. Kaká. Drawing Brozitsky to make a needless challenge and concede the free kick. Vasily Brozitsky, who missed the European Championships with a thigh injury. His brother Alexei, his twin brother Alexei, was never present in Poland. He was amongst the subs available to Fabio Capello this evening. Dani Alves. Fernando. Neymar just trying to barge into the back of the defender there and push him off balance. Looks to have caught him in the face as he did so. Let's get a close-up view of this. Oh yes, that's the left forearm, isn't it, from the youngster that's made contact with Anyukov. Bit of a worrying start this for Luis Felipe Scolari. Second spell in charge of the Brazilian national side, of course. Still looking for his first win. Beaten last time in London. Just up the road at Wembley against England. They were two up at half-time in Geneva on Thursday against Italy, but finished up drawing that one 2-2. This looks a little bit more promising though. Oscar finding Kaká. Why didn't he go himself there? There was a big gap. Tried to reverse it back to Oscar, and Russia can plug the gap and go forward themselves. Marcello. Neymar again leaning into Anyukov. Marcello takes over, romping forward. Ignashevich blocks him. Easy one for referee Howard Webb to call. Who was in charge a couple of years ago when Brazil beat Scotland at the Emirates, home of Arsenal Football Club. So a first opportunity here for Brazil to threaten Vladimir Gabulov in the Russian goal. David Luiz in the box supporting Fred. Thiago Silva in there too. Two full-backs, Dani Alves and Marcelo, over the free kick. Filled in by Marcelo, good delivery. Well dealt with by the Russian rear guard. Oscar to collect. Brilliant ball in. Despite his best attempts, Neymar couldn't quite supply the finish. Having to stretch. Real venom on the cross from Oscar. Look at the curl as well. Really impossible for the goalkeeper to deal with that. It's excellent defensive work from Alexander Andjukov. Dani Alves, Oscar. Nate. Just reaches Kaká. Oscar. Russia calmly able to clear their lines, but they found David Luiz. Oh, it's a beautiful ball in. Hooked away by Ignashevich. Fred couldn't get to it. And just behind him, Neymar was denied by Ignashevich. Well, twice now the Chelsea players, first Oscar and then David Luiz, have produced real Premier League quality as Brazil look to finally get involved in this game after Russia dominated the opening 15 minutes. That's a terrific cross. Neymar couldn't quite kill it on his midriff. As it bounced away, Ignashevich picked his moment to hook it away. Finally then, Brazil beginning to show their undoubted quality. Russia are, under Fabio Capello, a very tough nut to crack though. Five clean sheets in the seven games that he's been in charge of. And it's going to be Fernando. And it's going to be a goal kick. In his third cap for his country, plays his club football in Brazil with Grêmio. Great success with the junior sides of Brazil. It's a very cold evening, but hasn't stopped one or two coming out in inappropriate garb. Bogdarin looking for a Kurchikov away by Thiago Silva. Marcelo, Neymar, looking to get a second bite, but look how he's skipped away from Bistroff, or certainly looked like he was going to before Bistroff had another dig. Beginning to win a lot of free kicks, Brazil. Luiz again making his way into the Russian penalty area. Back here for Fernando. And there is David Luiz. Really spotted that the flag had been raised. Or did he imagine it? Well, offside. Shidakov has given it away. Dani Alves. Brazil have played four games since their last victory. Since that defeat to England, they were also beaten by Argentina in Buenos Aires in November. Drawn with Italy and Colombia. And the last victory in October by 4-0. six consecutive victories, which included an 8-0 against China. Luis finding Hernanes. Kaká. Marcelo. Fernando. Now Oscar. How close Oshchenko has got to him to cut down his space. Luis, nicely done by Alves. He went for the return. Oscar knew what he was trying to do, couldn't quite achieve it. Given away cheaply by Kokorin. Good work from Dani Alves. Too strong for Fred. Score sheet in that 2-2 draw against Italy. Fred, the opening goal. Hasn't taken Fabio Capello long to lick this promising Russian side into shape. Big surprise that they went out at the group stage of the European Championships last summer, especially given the fact that they wiped the floor with their first opposition in that competition. The Czech Republic beat them 4-1. Just lost their way under Dick Advocaat. Drew their next game against the host Poland, and then that surprise defeat to Greece, and they were heading home. And even managed to qualify for the last two World Cups. Tipped by Slovenia in the playoffs for the South African tournament under Gus Hiddink. Oshchenko fouled by Oscar. Shirakov, Fazulin, Glushakov, underneath that. Beautiful balance from Kaká. Now Marcelo. Beautiful pass for Neymar. Fred waits in the centre. And Neymar went for goal himself. Fred might be disappointed that that wasn't squared to him. Fantastic ball forward from Marcelo. Look how Neymar has found the space here, but look where Fred is by the penalty spot. A little bit more relaxed this evening than he did when he was in that dugout for Chelsea as their manager. Although in the build-up to this one, Scolari was saying it wasn't that bad, his seven-month spell here. When he left, Chelsea were third. They were through to the knockout stages of the Champions League, and they'd also made progress in the FA Cup. But I'm afraid, as other managers have since discovered, that isn't good enough at Chelsea. Nice feet for Kaká. Shevchenko did just enough. Oscar. Dani Alves with the crossing, cut out by Ignashevic. Oh, the miscued by Shevchenko. Working hard. Russia collecting it with Shidakov. Ignashevic. Shevchenko fouled by Dani Alves. Hoping for his fourth Spanish title this season with Barcelona. So through to the Champions League quarter-finals again. Shevchenko cut out by Fernando. Pass was intended for Neymar. Cut out by Anyukov, forward by Plushakov. Good strength by Hernanez. No advantage forthcoming, so Brazil get the free kick. Half an hour played, still awaiting the first goal at Stamford Bridge, but it's very, very rare that Brazil play and don't score. In fact, it's 18 months since their last blank, September 2011, a 0-0 draw away to Argentina. They've played 20 games since then and they've scored in them all. It's a little bit tight through the centre. Shevchenko unable to find Kurtsakov. Kaká. David Luiz, into the feet of Neymar, Fred nudging it on. Russia with a chance to bring it away far side. Astroff able to get away from Marcello. Alves can't find Oscar. Shidakov now for Russia. Vezelin finally finds Bistrov. Vezelin again. He's thrown Marcello off his set. Shot was blocked by Hernanez. Brazil now with plenty of players back behind the ball. Good work from David Luiz. Carrying it towards halfway. Options right, left and through the centre. Looks for Neymar. Neymar's got movement to his left but ignores it. Tries to go through himself. Actually cleared by Vasily Berezutsky. Signs of frustration from one or two of Neymar's colleagues here, but if anybody can do it, he can. Marcello in towards Fred, couldn't quite get the touch required. Didn't need much of a nudge that. Again, good delivery from Marcello. Fred knew what was coming, knew where he had to get to. Couldn't quite nudge it onwards. Shukov getting the better of Kaká. Referee took evasive action in the nick of time. Shukov. There's Anyukov. Took it beautifully. Important interception by Anyukov. And here come Russia again with Fazulin. Stopped in the end by Hernandez. And Marcello brought down. Well, it has been a regular feature of Brazil's global tour. Such a hugely popular attraction, and so many people taking up the opportunity to see arguably the most famous international team in the world. The only side, of course, the only country that has won the World Cup on five separate occasions. And they'll be big favourites next summer when they host the tournament for the second time in their history. Back in 1950, it didn't quite go their way. They lost the final to Uruguay, a game that is still remembered very painfully. The Mexican wave sweeping around Stamford Bridge now. As Oscar collects, Neymar up ahead to his left. Marcello. Fernando. Oscar. Marcello. Beautiful reverse ball from Kaká that very nearly found Neymar. But Russia continued to defend well. Shirokov away from Fernando. Stopped by Thiago Silva. This is turning into a really thorough examination for Brazil. You should expect Russia, one of the better teams in Europe these days. David Luiz hurries it forwards. Neymar this time impeded by Anyukov. Fans loving the occasion. And that Mexican wave will help them keep warm. And seasonally cold for this time of the year in London. Shukov forward. Nicely done by Thiago Silva. It's too strong for Dani Alves. Pockets of Russian support here too. I'll tell you one Russian who's not here, the Chelsea owner, Roman Abramovich. Although one of his former managers, Jose Mourinho, is a special guest of the Brazilian FA. the current Chelsea manager is here too, Rafa Benitez. Fezulin for Anyukov. Upwards rather than away by Thiago Silva. That's a bettered clearance by David Luiz, but here's Fezulin again. Ischenko, Shirakov. Oh, excellent work from Marcello. Full stretch, vital interception. Neymar working hard. Hernanes. Fernando. Kaká. Dani Alves creeping forward on this right-hand side. Blocked by Ischenko. Bring it back from Oscar. Able to stab that into the path of Kaká. Dani Alves. Oscar. Plenty back again for Russia. Good work from Ischenko. Even neater from Fezulin. Forward now for Kurtsakov. Faced by David Luiz. Looks for support. Arrives in the shape of Fezulin. Julio César got a touch on that, but I thought he did. Fezulin certainly felt that was the case, but I think that the referee has given a goal kick. Brilliant move by Russia. Fezulin heavily involved. Kurtsakov holding up the ball, looking for the run of Fezulin. Now look at this shot. Look at a clearer view from this angle, whether or not the goalkeeper got a touch. Well, I'm pretty convinced that he did. Not sure that it would have gone in, but I am pretty certain that Julio César got fingers to that. Referee felt otherwise, and goal kick has been taken. Dani Alves into the feet of Fred, pushed away by Ignashevich. For Anyukov, Klushikov, Fezulin. Klushikov for Ischenko. Well read by Fernando, but that was too short. Fezulin quickly in for Russia. From Klushikov. Brazilian fans don't have to wait too long to see their national side in action again. A week on Saturday, they take on Bolivia, and then later in April, they face Chile. Those games back in South America, and Scolari has said that he will rest the European-based players for those matches. Chance to look at some of the Brazilian-based boys. Kurtsakov for Russia. Last couple of minutes of this first half. Marcello. to pass. Neymar, only Fred ahead. Trying to link up with Fred now. Sure if that return from Fred was an attempt at goal or an attempt at backheel into the path of Neymar. Either way, it didn't come off. This looks promising. Kosakoff with a shot. Bistroff with the initial approach. He wanted it laid back to him. Kosakoff had other ideas. It's a really good run from Bistroff, and Kosakoff on his favourite left foot really had a thump at that. It was always rising though. 30 years of age now, Alexandra Kosakoff. Was involved in Russia's last World Cup campaign in 2002. Oscar, away by Eschenko, gathered by Fazulin, and that was weak. Last few seconds of the first half, I'm not sure if we'll see any added time, to be fair. The game has flown by at a good pace. Neither team has had the need to bring on a physio, no injuries at all, and no suggestion of time wasting, and indeed, bang on 45 minutes. Referee Howard Webb blows for half time. Fabio Capello, I would suggest, would be the happier of the two coaches. Brazil have spluttered somewhat, just flashes of Neymar and co. But the opening from Russia was very bright indeed, and that Ignashevich free kick that had Julio Cesar troubled for a moment in the Brazilian goal. But at half time, it's honours even at Stamford Bridge. It's Brazil 0, Russia 0. Welcome back to Stamford Bridge then, as we get ready for the second half of this international friendly between Brazil and Russia. Nil-nil at half-time. As referee Howard Webb gets us back underway, Russia in the all-red strip, attacking the goal away to our right-hand side. They were the better of the two sides in the opening 15 minutes or so. Brazil improved after that, but still failed to test Vladimir Gavrilov in the Russian goal. Russia have made several changes at the start of this second period. We'll run through those in just a second for you as we wait to see what Brazil will do with this free kick. Marcelo going short. And he shows a lovely turn. Oscar nudging into the path of Kaká. He's done well to get to the byline, eventually blocked by Berezutsky. Didn't see enough of this from Brazil in the first half. Oscar and Neymar, the three real genuine flair players in this Brazilian team, didn't really get going. Oscar's free kick headed away at the near post by Zhirkov, one of the Russian changes at the break. Former Chelsea player, of course, Yuri Zhirkov. Thiago Silva. It's a shocking pass. And in steps Oleg Shatov, one of the three substitutes, into the path here of Shirakov. Cheeky backheel that didn't quite find Kurtsakov. Marcelo able to clear for Brazil. It was all of Brazil's own doing. Very poor pass from Thiago Silva. Filled in by Shirakov. Dani Alves does just enough. Shirakov was on his shoulder. Goal kick given. Shirakov now with Anji in Russia. Never present at the European Championships. He was also involved in 2008 campaign for Russia. This is 57th cap, but for a player who has scored his goals for his club sides down the years, he's never scored an international goal. So let's get the confirmation of these changes then. Shatov, Zhirkov and Kombarov are the three that have come on. Adjusted tactically in the second half. It's now Neymar down the right and Oscar on the left-hand side. Switching flanks. No way through for Shatov. And here come Brazil with Kaká. Oscar, Fred and Neymar to his right. Here's the Chelsea man, Oscar, finding a bit of room, picking out Kaká. Is there room to get the shot away? Not quite. The gap plugged by Eschenko. Back here for Hernanes. Kill beautifully far side for Neymar. It's good defending again from Russia. Two Brazilians surrounded by four Russians. Hey. It's this game pitting against each other, the World Cup hosts of 2014 and the World Cup hosts of 2018. Cello with the throw. Fred. Fernando. Just able to break down Russia's well-drilled defensive lines at the moment, Brazil. Maybe a bit of room here for Hernanes. Now Neymar up against Kombarov. Goalkeeper made a bit of a meal of that, Gavrilov. I think it was intended as a cross from Neymar. In the end, it became a shot. Gavrilov almost dropped it into his own goal. most impressive goalkeeping you'll ever see. Foul here by David Luiz, a Russian free kick. Shatov plays it in. Grushakov needed a better first touch there. Neymar took it beautifully in his stride. Changes gear. Stopped by Grushakov. This evening, he's had a tendency just to overdo things, Neymar. Zhirkov. A bar off to his left, ignored for the time being. Shirakov, the captain. Grushakov waits by the penalty spot. Fazulin for Russia. A bar off, Shirakov. The flick didn't quite work. Cello looking to run away from Shatov. Left-back berth now under threat from Felipe Luis of Atletico Madrid. Neymar back on the left-hand side. Rolling into the path of Kaká, it was slightly behind him. Hernández. Neymar lets it run. This is Oscar. He's just offside. Work from the Russian back line. Leaving Oscar a yard ahead of them. Scored 9 goals for Chelsea this season, but only one of them has come in the Premier League. Chipped in regularly in the Champions League and the domestic cup competitions. Chelsea, of course, into the quarterfinals of the Europa League and quarterfinals of the FA Cup. They face a replay here against the English league leaders, Manchester United, in a week's time. David Luiz, that was a bit short. Marcelo working hard to try and reclaim it for Brazil. Excellent work, looked like he was impeded to me by Shatov. So what Scolari is appealing for? Well, there's Hulk, one of the subs available to the Brazilian coach this evening. Ironically, a player who plays his club football in Russia. A few of his teammates at Zenit St. Petersburg are wearing red this evening. Thiago Silva for David Luiz. Kaká. Dani Alves. Hernández. Enough for Thiago Silva. Kaká. Away from one. Away from two. Away from three. He's keeping on going here, Kaká. It's a terrific run. Grushakov, in the end, able to nibble it off his toes and turn it behind for the corner. We're rolling back the years here for Kaká as he breezed past three or four in red, trying to work the 1-2. He will now take the corner. Thiago Silva attacking the near post. His flick, David Luiz got a toe on that as well. It will be a goal kick, despite what the Chelsea man feels. Two centre defenders almost combining here. David Luiz yet to score in the gold jersey. He's weighed in with four this season for Chelsea. Second full season at the club. Hernandez and Fernando getting in each other's way, but Hernandez somehow has retained the ball. Hernandez just pushed by Zhirkov. Brazil's free kick. Since 2003, only 25 of Brazil's 152 games have been on Brazilian soil. Such a global brand now, such huge interest in Brazil all over the world. They've played games, home games at that, across Europe in Sweden, Germany, France, Poland, Switzerland. This is the 14th time they've staged a home game in England. Been across London. It's, Arsenal and Tottenham, they've been at Pride Park in Derby. Also play home games in Qatar and the United Arab Emirates. They're a big draw wherever they go. Again, plenty of English mad football fans taking the opportunity to see them in the flesh again. Neymar, and he turn on the magic. Oscar takes over. Eventually the whistle is gone. And eventually Brazil get the free kick. Zhirkov felt that Oscar made a bit of a meal of this. The referee was perfectly positioned. For a moment to go, Vladimir Gavrilov. A real mess with a pretty straightforward cross from Neymar. I think that will be in the minds of the likes of David Luiz as he sets up this free kick. Howard Webb ensuring that the wall is the requisite distance away from the ball. Five in that wall. David Luiz, we saw him carefully place the ball down. He's got the valve of the ball facing his boot. David Luiz into the wall. One of the Russians has gone down in that wall. And as the ball disappears beyond halfway, the referee calls a temporary halt to proceedings. Wesley Berezitsky is the man down in the centre of that wall. He caught it in the face. 6 foot 3 inches of Vasily Berezitsky, but he was felled like a giant there. Somebody on the pitch who shouldn't be, as Vasily Berezitsky is helped off it momentarily. Well, these countries have only drawn once before. 7 victories for Brazil, just the 1 for Russia. First ever game between Brazil and Russia was at the 1958 World Cup in Gothenburg. First ever game at a World Cup finals for Pelé. He didn't score in that 2-0 victory. Pavard got both. He was also a scorer in the World Cup final itself. That again, some 24 years later at the World Cup 82 in Spain. 2-1 for Brazil that time in Sevilla. Socrates and Eder, the scorers on that occasion. Here we played an hour. We're still awaiting the first goal. I don't think it'll be long before Scolari makes a change or two for Brazil. Fernando Here's David Luiz. Marcelo rolled forward, of course. Losing out to Shatov. It's too strong by Fazulin. In steps David Luiz. Over the top for Fred. Flag was eventually raised, but as it's with the goalkeeper, referee Webb plays on. Here's Kombarov for Russia. Fazulin. Shatov. Terrible walk. He was looking for Zhirkov, completely understruck it. And Brazil come forward with Neymar. Now Kaká. Fred waits by the penalty spot. And way past Perezutski again. And Russia have been very impressive this evening. It's easy to see why they've kept so many clean sheets and they've picked up so many wins. 4-4 in their World Cup qualifiers, remember. Conceded a goal in those games either, but they're under pressure here. Kaká in behind Shatov momentarily. And he's won the corner. Scolari, World Cup winner with Brazil, remember, in 2002 in Japan and Korea. And Germany in the final. And looking to repeat that 12 years on. Here comes the corner kick. Scolari appointed in November. As Brazil dispensed with the services of Mario Menezes. And just over 2 years in charge of the national side. Won 21 of his 33 games, but lost six times. And three of those six defeats were against bitter rivals Argentina. And eventually the powers that be felt that he wasn't the man to guide them to glory on home soil in the summer of 2014. Here's Oscar to deliver. Beautiful ball, Neymar couldn't get over it, in goes Kaká. And still good defending from Russia, out as far as Hernanes. Marcelo on his weaker right side, but it's on target. Safely fielded by Gavrilov. And it's Zhirkov for Russia. Ushakov, Fazulin, Ischenko, Fazulin, and away was David Luiz. A bouncing ball that Hernanes does brilliantly well to bring down in Brazil's favour. Possession quickly tossed away unnecessarily by Oscar. Shirokov for Russia. Fazulin. Neschenko, lovely early ball off the path of Shirokov, who was stopped by Thiago Silva. Oscar. Neskaká. By Shirokov. He was actually injured himself in that challenge. And here's that opportunity that almost brought Brazil the opening goal. Neymar just trying to tee this up for somebody else. He clearly felt he couldn't get the header on target from that kind of narrow angle. Goals in 29 appearances for Brazil before tonight, Neymar. Part of the Brazilian team that won a silver medal in London at the Olympics. And here's the challenge. It's a tired one from Shirokov. He's certainly come out of it the worst, the Zenit midfielder. Yeah, thumbs up from the medical team, so Shirokov might well come back, but what is clear is that Brazil are making their first change. It's the man they call Hulk to come on. It looks as though it's the Chelsea player Oscar who will make way. He's enjoyed his most impressive evening's work, Oscar. And he's replaced by the man who plays his club football in Russia, Hulk. And as we enter the last quarter of the game, of a free kick. Good work from Marcelo. Kaká, Neymar, running into Glushakov. And now Kombarov with a chance to clear for Russia. Hulk, who cost Zenit St. Petersburg €60 million when he joined them in September from Porto. His first impact is to bring Kombarov crashing to the ground. Ball has gone out. Brazil's throw. Shirokov has had some treatment. He's now able to come back. Sitting in behind Kurtsakov as the central attacking midfielder for Russia, with the onus to get back whenever his team need him, but he's got the legs at the moment, and Hernandez has picked out Kaká far side, stopped by Kombarov. Dani Alves to cross, up goes Neymar, but Gavrilov almost made that look easier than it was. Shut off for Russia. Too strong from Eschenko. Round about now in the first half that Brazil enjoyed their most impressive spell. We need to rediscover that and improve on it, because Gavrilov throughout the evening hasn't been tested as yet. Neymar. Don't think it was intended for Kaká, but I'm not sure that it was going to reach Dani Alves beyond him. Glushakov looking for Kurtsakov. Instead, it's Thiago Silva. Kaká trying to get the better of Kombarov again. This time he's been fouled. This time Brazil get the free kick. Dani Alves to take. David Luiz making his way forward. Milošević has an eye on him. Stabbed away by Shirokov. Driven forward by Marcelo. And it's reached Neymar. Neymar for the curler. Too close to the goalkeeper. At least he's been forced to make a save now. Found space here cleverly, Neymar. Just looking to bend this in at the far post, but in the end, it's straight out the goalkeeper. Glushakov. Eschenko, Shirokov, came off shot off last, and it's Marcelo with the throw. So Brazil, 20 minutes away from their first blank in 18 months. Hernanez. That's a yellow card for the Lazio midfielder. Referee perfectly positioned to see that. The ball's long gone. It's an over-the-top challenge from Hernanez. Not in control of his body. Here come Russia again. Zhirkov for Lombardov. Zhirkov has continued his run. Lovely pullback here. Kurtsakov! Fantastic block, but the chance is still there for Shirakov. Can't get it away. Now another opportunity for Fazilin. And here's Zhirkov. And surely Shirakov away again. And now it's in. Fazilin puts Russia in front. It took them long enough. So many chances. But finally, Viktor Fazilin puts Russia ahead. Well, no great emotion from the coach, Fabio Capello, but Brazil are in big trouble here. They were opened up down their left-hand side. Zhirkov with the pullback, Kurtsakov had his shot blocked, and after that, well, more than a few had a stab. Shirakov, then Fazilin, then Zhirkov, Shirakov again off the line, and finally knocked in by Fazilin. And too many in goal were standing around rather than clearing that football. Russia now on course for their first victory over the mighty Brazil for 33 years. Viktor Fazilin with his third international goal in only his seventh appearance. Now Brazil under pressure to avoid defeat. Dani Alves with a cross. It's a Brazilian corner. Friendly or not, any time you beat Brazil is a memorable occasion. And Russia are under 20 minutes away from achieving that goal. Dani Alves with a corner. Neymar went down in the box. Here's hope for Brazil. Hasn't been able to get involved in the game since he came on. And couldn't control it there. Russia can break with Zhirkov. Shirakov wanted it through the centre. Instead, it's the goal scorer, Fazilin. Kurtsakov. Beaten by England, held by Italy, and now losing to Russia. It hasn't been a magnificent return so far for Felipe Scolari. And Fazilin very nearly dispossessed Fernando. Kambanov had got hold of the shirt of Kaká. Brazil have seen more of the ball in this second half than they did in the first, but they haven't achieved much with it. Neymar dispossessed by Eschenko, driven forward by David Luiz. Beautiful pass. This is Hulk now, looking dangerous. And driven well wide by Marcelo. But that was more like it from Brazil. Hulk driving into the danger area. Getting his head up here. Marcelo just able to wrap his foot round this and keep it on target. Fazilin. David Luiz to clear. Easy for Berezutsky. Zhirkov. He's added something since he came on. And it's fouled Fernando there. stopped by Glushakov. Brazil have Diego Costa ready to come on shortly. Another striker. Tips from Neymar, with him a free kick. Let's get on with it swiftly. Neymar, Marcello, firmly struck. I think it was probably just fading away from Fernando, but Gavrilov taking no risks. Diego Costa in his debut against Italy on Thursday, and he'll replace Kaká. He's struggling to hit the heights that he did earlier in his career. His lengthy injuries over the last three seasons have affected him. Diego Costa, who has scored 15 goals this season for Atletico Madrid, charged with the responsibility to find one from somewhere in the last 12 minutes or so that we have at Stamford Bridge. An awkward bobble in front of Gavrilov there in his 6-yard box. Time to do a bit of gardening. Hulk, Marcello, expects the bulk of the next 12 minutes or so to be played in the Russian half. Russia will be happy enough to soak up pressure. They look to hit Brazil on the counter. 1-0 will be a fabulous result for them, and further confirmation that they are heading in the right direction. Fernando, Hernanez, it's run here for Marcello, dinked in towards Fred, knocked away by Glushakov, good strength from Holt. Which way the throw? Brazil get the shout. Marcello, Fernando, just haven't possessed the wit or the invention to break down this well-drilled Russian side so far, Brazil. And time is not on their side as Neymar takes a tumble. Kombarov concedes the free kick. Foot of Hulk, suggesting it will be an in-swinger here, looking for the likes of David Luiz or Fred to get a little touch to help it in. And that was David Luiz, but the flag was raised. Referee Webb happy to allow play to continue. Shchenko, now Glushakov. Shirakov on towards Kursakov, but David Luiz back there to clear for Brazil. It's Russia coming into this game after the disappointment of having their World Cup qualifier on Friday called off. They were supposed to be playing Northern Ireland at Windsor Park, but the surface there was under several inches of snow. Still 4 points clear at the top, though, because their nearest rivals, Portugal and Israel, drew 3-3. Here's Hulk for Brazil. Now Marcello. Hulk. Pass one, and then Eschenko is there to close him down again. Klyushchenkov makes it difficult for Marcello. Just going back to Russia's bid to qualify for Brazil 2014. If they're to take 12 more points from their next six games, they will win the group, regardless of what other teams do. On paper, having picked up 12 points from their first four, and having already beaten Portugal 1-0 and Israel 4-0, you would think that Russia are pretty much certainties to be amongst the first to book their passage to Brazil next summer. And tonight's evidence, he might be amongst the dark horses. He was in charge of England, Fabio Capello's side, never really got to grips of things. And although they got out of their group, they were quickly knocked out by Germany. Here for Marcello. Shirokov again, the Russian defender that brought him down. Hernanez. Neymar. Marcello. Now Hulk. Good ball in. Fred got his foot to it, but it's good defending again from Berezitsky. Fred has been kept very quiet this evening by Vasily Berezitsky. Fred might have had a point that came off the Russian last, but goal kick given. And the Russian support proud of this display. Off against David Luiz. Looking to switch it. He's found Zhirkov though. Instead, Dani Alves has invited Neymar to get forward. Releasing it for Hernanez. Again, red shirt swarming around him. Can't pick the pass. Berezitsky to nod clear. Anywhere will do for Zhirkov. He's got a bit of a muscle problem there. He came on at half time. Looks as though he's going to have to leave the field 5 minutes early. Irritating for Capello, but not the end of the world. No restriction on substitutions this evening. Bench hurriedly trying to get another substitute ready. Zhirkov hobbles off. Maxim Grigoriev, 22-year-old from Lokomotiv Moscow, comes on for his second appearance, his debut last November in the 2-2 draw against the USA. He only lasted 11 minutes in that game. Forward by Shirokov. Kurtsakov will chase, as he has everything this evening. Marcello. Still no suggestion that Brazil can find an equaliser here. Marcello has picked out Hulk. Clumsy challenge just outside the area, I think, from Eschenko. It's a yellow card for the fullback. Movement by Hulk, well found by Marcello. Clumsy from Eschenko. Brazil's free kick now then. An opportunity. If ever there was one. Thiago Silva and David Luiz are there. Scolari with fingers crossed, I'm sure. Fernandes, what a waste. What a waste. Sums up Brazil's efforts on goal this evening. Lacking in quality. And tonight's evidence, Luiz Felipe Scolari has a lot to do to turn this Brazilian side into world champions in the making in just 15 months' time. Of course, later this year, we'll have the Confederations Cup in Brazil as the various venues for the World Cup get a chance to rehearse the big event. Brazil have been drawn in a group, including Japan, Mexico and Italy. And prior to that tournament in June, they'll have friendlies against England and France. Next up, remember, next month, Bolivia and Chile. Can they find an equaliser? As we enter the last minute at Stamford Bridge, David Luiz. Back from Hernandez for Marcello. Hulk. Nice movement. Marcello wants it back. Here he is. Fred waits in the centre. Fred! Goal! 1-1. Brilliant move by Brazil. Just when you thought it was all over and they were going to be beaten, Scolari's side turn on the style. Their most fluid move of the night. Saved until the very last moments of the night. And Fred makes it 4-4 for him. Marcello, who's arguably been the pick of their players today, going for the reverse ball here from Hulk. Perfect delivery. And Fred couldn't miss. It's all about the timing of his run to stay onside, get ahead of the last defender, Ignacevic, and then just help it in to an open goal. Relief for Scolari. And the Brazilian support at Stamford Bridge. Most of the night, Fred hasn't been able to free himself from the shackles of Messrs. Ignacevic and Berezutsky. He did that, and to devastating effect. Having equalised, is there time for Brazil to win it? In comes the cross from Neymar. Three minutes of added time to come. Brazil's throw. Neymar, Fred, Marcello, and now Hulk. They're queuing up again in the centre. And Fred this time couldn't get to it, but Marcello has reclaimed it. Desperate defending here from Russia. Why have Brazil waited this long? Marcello and Hulk again in good combination. And Klushikov with the block. Well, now they're opening Russia up at will. I thought it was a corner. Hulk certainly did, but a goal kick has been given. Well, balance of play, I'm certain that Brazil don't deserve to win this game, but the way that they're playing now, they are threatening to find that winning goal. Fabio Capello, who's looked pretty relaxed throughout the evening as the game plan has worked pretty much to perfection, suddenly looks a worried man. Launched by Julio Cesar. Thiago Silva. Marcelo. Stopped by Glushakov. There's Fazulin. Goyev. Glushakov. What a pass that is. Kurtsakov can rush and get in front again. Real chance. And Shidakov plays it over the crossbar. Well, it's been the most exciting part of the evening, this. Good chance at both ends. Slightly behind Shidakov. Had to stretch behind him to make connection. Has had one or two half chances this evening, Roman Shidakov. Free Howard Webb checks the wristwatch and blows for time. It finishes all square at Stamford Bridge. Felipe Scolari still looking for his first win in his second spell as coach of Brazil. Meanwhile, Fabio Capello's Russia now 8 games unbeaten. They took the lead in 73 minutes through Victor Fazulin. Brazil left it desperately late to level. In the last minute, Marcelo and Holt with a combination, and Fred with his fourth goal in 4 games to level it up at 1 apiece. Final score at Stamford Bridge then, Brazil 1, Russia 1.